Hello, so today I'm going to be showing you my gas mask respirators, antiques, and like just old Soviet stuff in general. So, yeah. Okay, so here is my collection. I've around year five stuff, like. So my first one that I ever got was the GP5. Actually no, it was this thing. The high altitude Russian flight suit. It was very expensive, like $300 Australian dollars. As you can see, it's very heavy, it's like 4 kg. Like 6-7 kg. It's heavy as hell. I might do a separate video on this one, just because it's very annoying to put on and take off, so I'll just be reviewing these things in view. Let's just review the smallest to biggest. So it's smallest, this is my most recent one, it's antique. Okay, as you can see, it is in this little plastic bag. I got it from a little holiday, little trip in Morpeth, pretty close to Hunter Valley. This is a, I'm not even entirely sure what bullet this is. First I thought it was an artillery, but this is way too small for artillery. I'm not an expert at guns or bullets or anything, but it says on here, I got it from an antique shop. I don't think, yeah, you can't see it. This is ground dog. What the hell did I say? It's kind of really hard to read. A cursive, sort of. From Port Stevens. What? Okay, I don't know. 9. Held during World War II in 1945. A little piece of local history. Interesting. This is from 1945, that's crazy to think. This thing's like the size of my hand. It's wider, if it's like this, it's wider than my hand, it's huge. Sand in there. Alright, next item. Next item, the PMG gas mask. To be more specific, the PMG one. It was another PMG, but that one looks more like the GP5, but with a speech diaphragm. This one, it's actually very small, like it can't even fit me. Like it can, but it's very hard to put on. Like very, you know. I'll show you when I'm trying to put. So as you can see, inside. I don't know if you can see. Inside is like you can see the filter thing. Where like the air from the filter would come from this little thing. I don't know, it's very hot. That thing right there, air comes from there. This is the, I believe, 40 millimeter, correct me if I'm wrong, 40 millimeter Gost filter thing, so you can put the filter there. Only bad thing about this mask is, like, if you're getting a PMG, get a size up, because I thought size 3 might be a little too big, because with previous experiences with the GP5, it's a bit big, but it fits me, but it's a bit big. There's like some gaps like around here there. I thought a size 2 would actually fit me, but I was completely wrong. I've been trying to put my head in there. Look, I'll demonstrate, but the mic might do some weird noises. I can get it on, but then it just hangs off my head. Like, it looks like really weird. Oh, my hands hurt from doing that. Yeah, it clearly doesn't fit me. Even if I tried, it's very hard. And the one funny thing about it was, when I first put it on, my hair would look so weird. So, more information about it. This mask was used for soldiers that had like binoculars. They had like optics, like for example, You know the GP5 Dr. Eyes are like on a different angle. This one are like forward facing. So you could put like binoculars or like a sniper scope on it. This is a speech diaphragm. You can take it up. It's plastic. Plastic in there. This is the what is it called? Outtake. It is intake and outtake. Intake, outtake. So this is where the air that you breathe out comes from. This is the air from that you put the filter. I don't actually have the filter for this mask, so that's one problem. So next item. If you've reached this far into the video, comment down gas mask. Hashtag gas mask down in the comments. Okay, so the GP5. Here it is. It's in this bag. I got it for $21. It was a pretty good price. 21 Australian dollars. So the filter hose, I'm pretty sure the GP5 doesn't come with a hose. I'm not entirely sure, but it came with a filter too. I don't even put the filter on, obvious reasons. You should probably know if you watch other gas mask YouTubers who review gas masks, you know why. They should never trust the Soviet filter, like the old one. So let's review, let's see the GP5. So here is the bag that comes with the GP5. Or the mask is actually called the SMH62U. And basically the SMH62U, GP5, whatever you want to call it, was supposed to be a cheaper version of the older version, SMH41. And it was supposed to be cheaper. This one was for civilian use. And the SMH41 was for like military use. I'm trying to get it open here. Okay, got it open. Here's the hose. Very smelly. Doesn't smell good. I'm going to put it on the ground. Here's the real deal, the mask. And I'm gonna get the filter too. But it's sealed. I put it in this just in case if it does break down, I'm protected. I don't actually wear this. Very big. I'm not gonna take it out. Just for safety. If I didn't care about safety, then I would have took it out. Also, the lens replacements. I'm going to open this and show you what it is. This is in Russian writing. I'm going to try reading it, even though I'm not Russian. I am Macedonian. The fuck is that? I don't know what that says. This is... Ternace... Tatiana... Partia... Okay, I'm not going to read that anymore. And there's like these little... I don't even know how to put it on. Okay, I'll skip to the GP5. I'm going to have to put this. Okay, so here is the mask. It's a size 3. And it's dated back to... pretty sure this is the date. 85. Ooh, I don't even... I think that's the date. And this is the size 3. Let's put it on. Even the mic might sound weird. Well, I'm actually take this off and put it inside the mask.
As you can hear me, this probably sounds horrible. And I'm gonna put subtitles.
Okay, so it should be sealed with a thing. I'm not gonna worry about it for now. So you take and outtake and the arm. This is the thing.
Okay, Jesus Christ, that smells horrible. So, the thing that I was talking about the PMG is, this one has like eyes that are facing like a different way, so you can't actually put a binocular or a scope on like the PMG. I'm gonna put the hose on too, just to show you. This is a 40mm Ghost intake. This is the outtake. Only bad thing about these masks is if this breaks, pretty much any gas mask, if this happens actually, that breaks, basically the mask is useless, because let's say that like this rubber breaks, the gas will just flow in or whatever. And then the idea of this was to have like your filter in like a little haversack, little bag, and there'd be like a hole in the thing so you could put your filter, and it would be more better for fighting. Next item. Alright, so we have this one. This doesn't have a name. It's like one of those masks that you found on eBay. They're like those fake Chinese versions. It has a... I'll show you the filter. Actually, no, I'll show you that right now. Alright, so this mask does actually work, but it's like one of those Chinese rip-offs that you find on eBay, Wish, or whatever. I've got this one on eBay specifically, and the filter is a particulate. I'm not sure which rating it is. It's a... it looks like a KN95. You can see this is the particulate layer, and the charcoal, activated carbon, or whatever, is here. So I'm gonna put this one on. Oh my god. When was it this hard to put this off? It's the wrong way. How can I be this dumb? Fucking hell, bro. Okay. I'm gonna put it on. It has a 4-point strap system. So you could probably protect you against tear gas, I'm not entirely sure, but if it is like, this is more like an industrial mask, I'm pretty sure, industrial uses probably, so I'm gonna make a separate video to this. I'm gonna make a separate video to the Russian high altitude flight suit. I'm gonna give you some details about it. It's the VKKM. And the reason I know why this is because I know Svelik. I know the Svelik alphabet, not all of it. The B looking thing is a V, so it's VKK6M. What is that? Hold on. Whatever. Oh, this is getting heavy. I hope you enjoyed the video. And remember to like and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed. enjoyed.